This Tiny Teach is going to cover activation of helper T cells. The process begins when an antigen enters the body via a portal of entry. Once inside the body, the antigen will be phagocytized by an antigen-presenting cell. In this case, they happen to be using a macrophage as an example of an antigen-presenting cell. Once the antigen-presenting cell phagocytizes the antigen is sent to the lysosomes, where the enzymes within the lysosomes break down the antigen to epitopes. Then the antigen-presenting cell will display the epitope on its surface in the groove of MHC class 2. So here's the antigen-presenting cell, here's MHC class 2, here's the epitope being displayed in the groove. This antigen-presenting cell displaying epitope in MHC class 2 will then mix and mingle with inactive helper T cells in the lymph nodes, lymphoid organs, and lymphoid tissue. This antigen-presenting cell is in search of the correct inactive helper T cell to activate. We need to find a match between antigen-presenting cell, epitope, and MHC class 2, and inactive helper T cell receptor, and CD4 co-receptor. Once this match happens, then intercellular signals, or cytokines, they're also known as lymphokines, will be released, and this helper T cell that was inactive will become active. So let's look at the match a little more carefully. Here's a blow up of what the match looks like. Here's the antigen presenting cell displaying epitope and MHC class 2. Here's an inactive helper T cell that has a T cell receptor and a CD4 co-receptor. So notice how the match happens. Epitope and MHC class 2 has to match up with T cell receptor and CD4 co-receptor. Notice how the T cell receptor is a perfect fit for the epitope and how the CD4 co-receptor comes up and around and grabs on to the MHC class 2 protein. This is now a match. And again, the intercellular signals, the cytokines, are also what are also known as lymphokines, will be secreted, and this helper T cell will be activated. Once it's activated, it'll divide by mitosis to produce clones. Some of the clones will become memory T cells and stay behind in case the same antigen is encountered again in the future. The majority of the helper T cell clones become T helper 2 or T helper 1 cells. T helper 1 cells produce cytokines that activate macrophages, cytotoxic T cells, and natural killer cells. T helper 2 cells produce cytokines that activate B cells and stimulate antibody production by B cells.